Brendan Cuddy here with Randy Miller, Yankees beat reporters for NJ Advance Media. Randy, what's your biggest concern going into opening day, which is fast approaching?
Well, heading into Friday's game, Masahiro Tanaka was a concern because he's been so bad this spring, but his last spring training tune-up was pretty good. So I'm going to go with Greg Bird. Everybody all spring saying, just keep this guy healthy. That's all we need. Keep him healthy. He's going to hit. He's going to be another huge weapon in the lineup. And so far, through Friday's game, he was hitting 154, another bad day, 0-for-4. He does have some walks this spring. Aaron Boone, the manager, has been saying he likes his plate discipline. But in Friday's game in the first inning, he struck out at a bad pitch. So I just don't think it's a cure-all. I know Aaron Boone said the other day that when he was a player, the best spring training he had, he went into the season and couldn't hit. And one of the worst he had, he came in to the season and then he hit right away. So those things happen. But Bird is a guy that needs to prove himself, and he hasn't done it this spring.
I hear you there. For me, it's Brandon Drury, who took a pitch off the elbow in Friday's game against the Red Sox here.
That was scary.
Right. He went and ran the bases, but then Gene Monahan, Yankees assistant trainer, went out and checked on him, and the swelling didn't look so good. Opening day is real close. You worry about who's going to be the Yankees' starting third baseman. Is it going to be Ronald Torres? Does it become Tyler Wade? Brandon Drury has looked good this spring. He's been as advertised. That would be a tough loss for the Yankees if they had to start the season with Ronald Torres as a third baseman.
One thing to keep in mind, I know a lot of fans will be thinking that this means that Miguel Andujar, their top prospect, is automatically coming up. Aaron Boone kind of shot that down. Unless this is a disabled list thing, and I don't think it is, they're going to go with Torres and go with Wade. Neil Walker's a guy that could be in the mix, but he's more of a second baseman option. I think they would end up moving Wade over and splitting him and Torres there. But that's something to keep your eye on, because Drury has looked very good in the field. He hasn't hit a whole lot of late, but he's made good contact, and he's certainly a fiery guy, which is going to be a good guy for that lineup and in the locker room.